And we're back. This time, our program has the Winston object, but we're only displaying the age of Winston. That's because I want to show you how we could change Winston's age, because you know eventually, Winston has to get older. Let's remember what it'd be like if we were just using simple variables. We have var Winston age equals 19, and then if we wanted to change it, we would say Winston age equals 20, and that would change the value stored in that variable. It's really, really similar for object properties. We can just say Winston.age equals 20. And then we've changed the value stored in the age property of the Winston object. Cool. So let's see if that worked. We'll take our text command, put it below, change the y. Ta-da! Winston got older. So easy. Okay, so now let's try, we were just adding one here. Let's do that more programmatically. Let's say Winston.age equals Winston.age plus 1. So what we're saying here is take the previous value of his age, add 1 to it, and then store it in the age property. And that should just end up adding 1 to whatever the previous value was. Let's see. Display it. Ha-da-da! He's 21. Getting so old. All right, now remember we have a shortcut for adding 1 to variables. And the same shortcut works with object properties. So we can say Winston.age plus plus. And let's see if that worked. Yep, and that really just did exactly the same thing as this line. It's just a shortcut so that we don't have to type as much. Now if we look at all this, this really looks like the situation for a loop. We keep on using the same code over and over, and the only thing we're changing is we're adding 1 to his age, and we're changing the y position so it's on a different line. So if we use the loop, it could be really easy to show him getting older and older and older and not have to use that much code. Let's say we'll make a loop to show Winston getting to 40 years old. He doesn't want to get any older than that because then he'd be wrinkly, and we'd have to call him Wrinkleston. All right, so we'll do a while loop, and we'll say while Winston.age is less than or equal to 40. And then inside here, we're going to display his age, and we're going to add 1 to his age each time. Okay, that worked, but everything is piled on top of each other. So we need to change the y position each time. And we'll just do Winston.age times 20 minus 200. Minus 300, okay. And we'll just minus 350. All right, that looks good. Let's delete the old stuff here. Ta-da, now we can see Winston getting older and older, but not so old that he'll be a Wrinkleston. Okay, so now we can see how to change the age. We can also add additional information in the Winston object as he gets older. Like maybe when he turns 30, he'll meet another programmer named Winifer, and he'll marry her. And no, he's not just going to marry her because she has such a great name. So what we can do is we can add a property by just saying Winston dot, and then the new property key, which will be wife, equals Winifer. Great. But we only want him to have this wife when he's at a good marrying age. So we'll say equals 30, and we'll go and move that inside here. Great. So now he has a wife, so, you know, they're happy, and then they have some kids a couple years later. So maybe when they're 32, we'll add some kids to the object to keep track of that. And they have twins, of course, because they're very productive. And Winston's twins will be named, of course, Winston Jr. and Winstonia. Beautiful. It's a great family. Great set of names. So you can see we can add new properties that are strings and arrays and anything we could have had in the original object. And so once this loop finishes, Winston.age will be 40, and Winston will have a wife who's Winifer and a twins, which is an array of two names. Huh, that's an awesome loop. But hey, if you don't like how this story ends for Winston, you could always spin off this program and tell your own story of his future, now that you know all about how to change object properties.